Well, you're continuing to watch this Children's Day special here on Startup Central with me, Nayantara Rai. When we talk about children, today there is, you know, the bad world of digital. We talk about cyberbullying. And frankly, there are no solutions globally. It's a new problem that parents, children, teachers, the world actually is grappling with. I've got with me a 14-year-old school child who is trying to find a solution. She's very brave. She's going to be talking to us about the solution that she's finding for this perennial problem that a lot of people don't know how to deal with. Nyay Mehta, she's all of 14 years old and she's here with us in our studio. Welcome. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
You're all of 14. I want to know what happened and what is this prototype and software, I believe, that you're working on?
Yes, so it's been a very interesting journey. I think I'm going to start from the start. So my dad's in the military and I've kept moving schools since I was a child. And when I moved schools, I realized that you get bullied because you're always a new kid, you always have to settle in. But I realized that bullying leaves scars and that it needs to be solved because it's not something a child can deal with on a regular basis. And school is not a place you come to deal with bullying. You come there to study, you come there for an education. And around this time, YEA came up, my Young Entrepreneurs Academy. It was a 6-month program where I got the chance, where I met Namrata Thapar ma'am actually, and I got the chance to...
And she heads this organization.
Yes, she heads this organization and she's an amazing person. She's been my mentor through this journey. She made me realize that there is a solution for bullying, which was basically something I had been thinking of since I was 9 or 10. And when I was 11, and when I was 11 or 12, I realized that, okay, its solution needs to be found. So, Enough, my service is an anti-bullying app. At least it started off as an anti-bullying app. And as I did research, so I actually won YEA in 2018. And then I started doing a little more research, make it a little more in-depth, because there are so many different types of bullying out there. And I realized that it's not just bullying anymore. There are concerns such as substance abuse, violence, harassment, suicidal tendencies. And we can see that in the major events that have happened, like the boy from the Dehradun school got killed in a school, and the child from GD Goenka, and the Ryan case that happened in 2017. So I decided that Enough, my service, can be used for not only bullying anymore, but it's more of an anonymous concern reporting system. So what Enough really does is that it provides you an anonymous website and an app where you can talk about your issues, you can report concerns, and those will go straight to your school administrator. My website and my app basically plan to do that. And I have a wristwatch, which is basically a personal security band, which has an audio alarm and an audio recording facility, which makes sure that children are safe at all times. Yeah, so that's what it is.
So basically, when people talk about these issues, I would imagine it's twofold. One is where maybe people who've gone through similar events or experiences are able to counsel each other or share experiences, or just not keep it in themselves anymore, not have it bottled up anymore. And the second aspect, from what I'm understanding, what you're telling me, is an anonymous snitching mechanism.
Yes, you can call it that. So,
which is very important.
Yes, so actually,
because the fear of not sharing.
Exactly. So a lot of kids are scared that, if someone comes to know,
or their
that
friends
I snitched,
get to know, this peer pressure.
That, you know, I snitched on the person who bullied him or her, then they will face the same repercussions. Most of the kids are scared about that. That, oh, maybe I'll be socially excluded. Maybe my friends will leave me. Maybe I'll also have to deal with that bullying. So that's what this anonymous app and website does. It makes sure that the children can report without having the fear of...
So basically your school administration gets to know that there is this child who is being bullied. They don't know who is telling.
Yes.
It could be the child themselves, or it could be
a
another...
parent or a victim,
a
or
classmate
a
or whatever.
Yes.
So parents also have access to this
app? Yes, parents also have access to this, because it ensures say a parent is feeling, one of my child's friends came to school today and there's something off with her behavior. They can report it. They can say, please check up on this child in school. Are they fine? Is their education going fine? Are their friends going, are their social relationships going fine? So it allows parents, victims and bystanders to report.
And they can all see the same material, or do you have different material that kids can see and different material that parents and teachers can see?
It's basically a reporting app, and there's just a small box where you can say, okay, when did the incident happen? How did it happen? And both parents and children get the same view, and it'll just go to the administrator. It's just a normal filling up.
Okay. You told me you have a wristwatch. What does a wristwatch do?
This is what my wristwatch is. It's still a prototype in the making.
It's actually pretty good looking as
So this is what we're planning to make. It's still being made in Taiwan. So I've talked to manufacturers in Taiwan, and my wristwatch is being made over there. But just for prototype's sake, this is what I showed at my panel discussion. So it's a personal security band, which has an alarm. A really loud alarm to say if a child is in, the child is in a situation where she is being beaten up or they're being harassed. So the alarm will attract attention and it'll startle the perpetrator till the child can run or escape. Then I also have an audio recording facility. Say someone's bullying you. You can record what they're saying and then use that as proof and send it with the incident report. You can upload it to the website or the mobile app and then send it to the school administrator as proof as well.
Forgive me for asking this, but maybe you can call me cynical because I'm much older than you. Is it misused as well? Like if friends have a fight or if there's, a boy and a girl break up or something?
Yeah, well, that is definitely, it can happen. But we're going to be training the school administration and the teachers with the help of child psychologists to understand how exactly to counter something, to understand whether or not it might be fake, to how to talk to the children after that. We're also going to be talking to our school counselors on how to, most of the times when someone bullies someone, 90% of the times, it's not intentional. Do you think it's fun?
Kids are mean growing up.
Yes. Sometimes you try just trying to have fun, you poke fun, but it hurts the person too much. Sometimes children might actually mean it. But most of the times when someone doesn't really mean it, it's important for them to realize what they're doing and for them to stop. And that's why we teach the counselors how to go through this.
You guys are teaching. How many of you are there?
Okay, so it's me as of right now, and I have a few child psychologists on board as well who are teaching counselors how to talk to children to make sure they don't feel, the children don't feel attacked, but they understand what they're doing. Yes.
And did you do all this on your own? How did it happen?
Okay. So I entered YA, like I told you, in 7th grade.
And you were 12 years old?
Yes, I was 12 years old. Mm. And I had amazing mentors. I had Miss Namita Thapar. I had Mr. Varun Agarwal as well. And I had so many children around me who explained, okay, maybe you can do this, maybe you can do that. So it's more of a peer learning and mentor learning experience as well. And throughout, so it's an entrepreneurship academy. So they teach you how to go about it, how to make your business plan, how to find investors, how to start your project, how to find partners, how to find...
So you've been pitching?
Yes, I have been pitching. So that's how I
won. Have you been successful?
Yes. So YA, towards the end of the program, you have to pitch your business plan to investors, and which is what I won.
You won that?
Yes.
Did you get money?
Yes.
How much did you get?
I got 50,000 rupees.
You got 50,000 rupees. Did you spend it on yourself or did you spend it on your business?
No, I spent it on developing my app.
So that's the first one of the big life lessons that you got?
Yes, definitely.
And how much time do you spend doing this, your homework, extracurricular activities or hobbies? How do you divide it?
So, I won't lie, time management is tough. Now that I'm in 9th grade, there's a lot of things to do. I have to prepare for college, I have to prepare
for exams. At 14 you're preparing for college?
Definitely, you need to do it now, you need to be keep
I want to college the right time for you.
Yeah. You need to keep in mind that, I need to do this, if this is what I want to do.
But this will help you in college admission.
Definitely. But I think you need to learn how to make use of every single minute. If you're in the bus, maybe you can ideate about, okay, who should I meet, who did I meet recently, who might help me, what are the actions I'm taking. You need to learn to be really fast with your work, but make sure that your grades are still there, perfectly.
Are you an A-plus kid?
Yes.
Are you an A-plus kid as well? Was that one of the conditions your parents maybe had, that if you're going to do this, you can't let the study suffer?
Yes, definitely. But my parents have been really helpful. They've helped me out when I've had tough times. Like, I know, I personally take a lot of stress. So my parents have always
been there. You're 14!
I know, but I often felt like, oh, maybe I don't know how to do this. My parents have always been there to kind of push me, like, no, everything's in your control. We'll help you. We'll sit with you. Like, my parents have stayed up night after night to explain subjects to me, to explain topics to me that I didn't understand because I didn't really have the time, that much time to give.
Now, making a website is not tough, you know. Nowadays,
yes,
you can do it really easily, right? But I think the attention to detail, the devil is in the detail,
definitely.
And that's what makes a good website.
Definitely.
So you're doing it on your own, or you've had to get help, or like, how are you doing
it? So the website was made on Wix.com, which is a really user-friendly website, and a little bit of coding, which one of my friends helped me with and my dad helped me with. The app, however, is, I'm not a coder, but I got the help from some technicians who helped me build my app.
Okay.
Yes.
So this is 100% your baby, if I can call it that.
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
Are you popular in school after this? Because do they look at you as that she's the one who wants to make snitching official and legitimize it?
Oh no, I mean, I've had friends. I mean, I've been bullied when I was a younger kid, but now I guess I've settled down a lot in my school. And yes, this has definitely been one factor that, oh, you know, she'll solve bullying.
Yeah.
But I've always been like the academic kid, or the child who kind of focuses on the studies more. But I also do a lot of sports. So that helps.
Of course, it always helps. But tell me something, you know, and as I wind this down, you know, so you're going to these workshops, I'm sure you read a lot as well. They always say an entrepreneur's journey is a lonely one. You're only 14. Would you say it's true?
Well, I don't think that's true because I have had so many mentors around me. I've had my peers encouraging me. I've had my parents. I've had investors come up to me and say, oh, you know, you should do this.
So what kind of investors?
So from companies like Make My Trip to angel investors, I've talked to a lot of people, especially through YES. They've given me the platform, they've given me the connections to talk to people. That's the basic amount of entrepreneur investors.
So besides the award that you won, have you managed to get money from other investors?
No, so I realized I gave it a little break because I was doing more research. Like I said at the start, it was just an anti-bullying app. But then over time, I realized that, okay, it needs to be much more than an anti-bullying app. It needs to be a concern addressing system. I've been doing more research. I've been going over my details. And now I'm at the stage where I'm pitching it to investors.
So, you know, when I was growing up, when my parents would ask me when I was 14, what do you want to be when you grow up? I was like, are you crazy? I'm only 14. I don't even know what I want to do tomorrow.
Yeah.
Is this what you want to do for the rest of your life?
Definitely. I mean, this can totally
Do you know be... that? Or like, is it this or is there some other thing that you may want to start?
I've always wanted to go into biotech.
Okay.
Yes. So engineering with biology has been one of the things I wanted to do. But I feel like in today's age, you don't have to stick to one career path. You can be a part-time entrepreneur, part-time engineer, or part-time writer. I've always felt like writing. Before I had the idea of enough, I've been writing poetry about this. I've been talking to my friends. I've been writing memoirs. So I feel that my interests lie over a broad field and I don't need to stick to one career path. I can always do different things.
We've talked about your entrepreneurial journey. Would you want to share some of the bad instances of bullying so that anybody who's watching you knows that they may be not alone?
Definitely. So I remember when I just entered one of my schools. So I was this kid, I was a little short. I'm still a little short for my age. And I had short hair. I never really paid attention to my looks a lot. So I had like a slight mustache over here, like you do when you have puberty. And a lot of people were very insensitive about it. They called me transgender, they called me bisexual. And I did not know what was wrong. And then I realized, oh, maybe it's because of this. And it kind of hit me really hard. That was one of the incidences that really hurt me.
So ladies and gentlemen, that's a case of actually not being beaten down, but standing up and doing something not just for yourself, but for the community at large. And for the entire team at ETNA, we wish you all the very best.
Thank you so much.